Like a boy with blue eyes?
What are you talking about?
Oh, help me. Get me off of my back.
Have you seen a little girl who looks like a boy with blue eyes around here?
What a stupid question. Buzz off.
Oh, no. Now it's been almost 12 years that I've looked for her.
Trying to find out whether you're a girl or a boy.
Who do you work for?
If you're a boy, you'll turn blue. But if you're really a girl, you'll turn purple.
Hey, he's getting away.
Let's go. Come on now. Come on, hurry up. Let's go. Come on. Hurry up. Let's go.
Now, which way did he go? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
It's time to get up now. Come on, get out of bed. No!
No! Hello, Gary.
I'm getting tired of this. You're 30 seconds late again.
Wait a minute. I got up on time. You're late.
You're always trying to make a fool out of me.
We're here now with your clothes. Please cooperate now and change your clothes.
Come back here. Come back.
Oh, that child.
Well, good morning, Opal. Give me my clothes. That's fine. I like these clothes better than the fancy ones. They're nice. See you. Huh? Oh, thank you.
Good morning. I hope that all goes well with you, Your Majesty, and that the country is feeling the growing pains of wealth and prosperity, and that your spirit...
Oh, it's the prince! The Grand Duke Duralumon!
I am honored that you would grant me an audience this morning, Your Majesty.
I'm glad you're still well.
Oh, not again.
I'd like to talk to you about the annual deer hunting party, sir. I think it should be done on a larger scale this year.
But we don't have much money.
Well, all we have to do is collect more tax from the people. Now, you just put your seal right here.
Oh, you want my seal? Well, you can do it yourself.
Yes, sir. I'll be back later on.
Good morning, Dad.
Will you take your cap off at once? And look at your clothes. You look more like a beggar than a prince.
But, Dad, I feel much more comfortable in these clothes.
Always remember that you are a prince, and you should keep your dignity at all times. Do you understand that? Don't say good morning, Dad, to me.
What should I say, then?
Quietly say good morning, Father.
Grand Duke Duralumon.
Oh, it's you, Nilan. That foolish, annoying young prince got in my way once again. He kept me from getting the king's seal
now
on purpose.
Now, calm down, sir. If the people find out that the prince is really a girl, she won't be able to succeed her father to the throne, you see. Only boys can inherit the throne in this country. You know that. I'll tell everyone the truth, and then you'll be king.
But don't forget something, Nilan. That young girl is very strong.
Now, you must learn that a young prince like yourself should not yard in front of his people as if he is bored. And also, you are not supposed to hiccup in public places. Furthermore, I must now instruct you in the fine art of table manners. And, of course, they are... Listen to me! You're reading cartoons again, and you know that they're bad for you. Why, when I was a young boy around your age, I studied many books that helped my mind.
Help, help, help.
Princess, I know this is your study hour. Now go back to your room.
I don't want to study, Mother, because all of my teachers are old men.
Princess, please behave.
See you later.
Princess, Princess, you poor thing. And you've grown up like this because of our country's law. I remember when you were born quite clearly.
People, I have good news. A prince has been born, and someday he'll be king. Yay! I deceived my people. I told them it was a boy instead of telling all of them the real truth, that it was a girl.
Your Majesty, you know a princess can't succeed to the throne according to the law of the land. You had to tell them that a new prince was born.
Yes, I know.
So he lied to everyone in our country.
The king had no choice. Don't you see what would have happened if they knew that it was a girl then? And you know that Duralumon is just waiting to get his hands on the throne, possibly at this
Your
very
Highness,
moment.
The Grand Duke Duralumon has now come to be received by
Wait
the beautiful
Wait for a
young
moment,
prince.
Please. The prince is not ready yet.
The time has been set up. Now hurry up.
What if he finds out the truth about the poor little child?
Put some little boy's toys close to the baby.
The Grand Duke Duralumon.
I hope that you grow up to be a very strong and healthy little prince.
We were lucky that he didn't find out about Princess. And there were times when I didn't know what would happen to her. Only a few people knew. Just the doctor, Gary, and the nurse. The years have flown by. A girl who pretends she's a boy. It's been such a strain to keep this secret inside of our hearts.
Princess. Ow!
Little Princess has become just like a boy in every one of her actions.
no happiness as a girl because of the law of our country. My dear daughter, it's too much for me to bear.
Prince, I see you're taking a ride by yourself.
Sir Nilon, I do not like you, so please leave.
I'm very sad to hear that. You see, I came here to ask you if you wanted a sword fight with me.
Sure.
Thank you very much.
Come on, let's fight.
Which one of us can do the best job with a needle and thread?
Nilon, I want to know why you've been sending killers after me. Now tell me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You hear me?
Hello there.
Who's there? Oh, who are you?
My name's Choppy.
Choppy? That's a funny name.
I've been looking for you for over 12 years. Aren't you a girl? Come on, I know that you're a girl.
I am not a little girl, silly.
You are a girl.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, I do.
But how did you know about that?
Well, I'm a little angel.
Angel?
Yes, let me explain. I left my cloud in heaven and have been looking all over for you. 12 years have passed, and I was told to make a very nice little girl out of you.
You are going to make a little girl out of me? Try if you can. But I'll make you a bet that you'll never be able to do it.
Well, I'll make you a bet, too.
Go away.
I'll see you later on, Princess. Take care now.
You are worthless. Three of you get together, and the only thing you can do to the prince is run away from him. What do you think I'm paying you good money for?
But, Sir Nilon, you couldn't do anything either, remember?
Be quiet. Didn't you have a chance to give him the medicine that tells whether he's a boy or a girl?
Well,
we did.
But I'm afraid that nothing has happened yet. Oh, look, it's acting. He's turning blue, and that means that Nilon really is a man, isn't he?
You idiot!
Oh. Sir Nilon, I've come at last.
Good, I've been waiting for you. Did you bring the medicine that I ordered?
Yes.
We give this medicine to someone, and they start speaking all of the truth. Hey!
Yes!
You know what this medicine can do for all of us?
Yes!
Now tell us what we have to do.
All of you will act as decoy.
And then what happens?
Then lead him to the roadless forest. There's a man-eating wolf there. And when he arrives, he won't know where he is. While he's walking around the area, the queen will tell us everything. I'm sure my plan won't fail. Soon every one of us will be the subjects of the new King Duralumon.
Well, I don't know. Let's see. I'm trying to remember if it's this way or that way.
I know you're all there. Please show yourselves. Gee, this is such a terrible place, isn't it?
Who's there?
It's Duke Duralumon, Your Highness.
Oh, it's you. And what do you want?
I purchased some very rare wine the other day, and I want you to try it. I'm sure that you'll enjoy its taste.
Thank you very much.
Nilon, you try this first.
You mean that you want me to test this wine first?
Yes, go on and try it.
Anything you say, sir. Oh.
You can see that it's perfectly harmless.
Gee, I'm lost. I don't think I can get out of this place.
It looks to me like you've lost your way, young man.
Yes, I'm afraid I have. How do I get out of here?
I'd better tell you now that there's a horrible man-eating wolf who has lived in this forest for many years. But there's an old house that is located quite near where you'll be safe from the wolf. Hurry up before he comes. Oh.
Thank you, old lady.
Well, Nilan, soon the medicine and the wine will start its truth-telling action.
And she'll tell us whether the prince is a boy or a girl. Oh, my plan is so wonderful, isn't it?
You're doing a lot of talking yourself, Nilan. Remember, you tasted that wine, too.
It's so dusty. Footprints of the wolf. He sure is a big one.
Something right now. You're in the bad wolf's house.
I was tricked.
Yes, that wolf lures everyone to his house, and then he comes and eats them alive, Princess. Those caps belong to some of his former meals.
Ooh.
I know the wolf is very soft-hearted towards little girls like you.
You mean I have to dress up like a girl?
If you want to stay alive.
No, I refuse to dress like a girl.
Children who are frightened of my monstrous mouth. Care for flowers? Or how about a little cake? Please stop that trembling. What do you want me to do with you?
Can you make yourself much smaller?
You mean like this? How does this suit you? Or tell me, how do you like this? Why, you? Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. What should I do now?
Thank you.
and my head hurts so.
It's not good for you if you keep a secret inside of your head, Your Highness, so I suggest that you let it out.
The secret is about my son. It's about my son.
Good! The Queen is trying to talk for us. Yes, indeed, I certainly had a good idea, didn't I, Duke Duralumon? We give the Queen the medicine, and presto, she tells us all of her intimate secrets.
What's going on?
Well, it seems that old Duralumon gave the Queen some wine that had some medicine in it, and...
Duralumon did that?
Oh.
Duralumon, what do you think you're doing?
Well, I'm just,
Get out!
Yes.
You know that you're really a girl.
I don't care now. I'm going to live and act just like a boy. And maybe someday I'll be able to straighten out this country of ours.